More now of my conversation with former Romney campaign chief Stuart Stevens. But let's talk about some of the stories that kind of blew up on that campaign, whether it was Mother Jones obtaining that video of Romney saying 47% of Americans are victims and feel entitled to government benefits, whether it was him saying binders full of women, which I first saw on Twitter during one of the presidential debates, whether it was Clint Eastwood's empty chair routine at the convention, which you defended, but later a lot of people said it was not a great moment for your campaign. Were those legitimate news stories, or do you think the media kind of pumped them up in a way that was unfair to your guy?
I think news is whatever people decide news is.
Well,
and I don't think that there is a legitimacy litmus test that you can put on it. News is what people are interested in. The question that news organizations have to ask themselves and do ask themselves every day is, what kind of news do we want to validate? Where do we want to be in this vast stream here of media? What do we want to cover? And I think that that's a question that every news organization is struggling with. And there is tremendous pressure to feed the immediate versus the long term. These are all things that you organizations struggle with, as you more. There are financial pressures now,
yes,
like never before.
Absolutely.
And the idea that you could send reporters out and they could spend 2 weeks in Ohio and they could talk to voters and they could get out of that, that's very difficult now.
You got a fair amount of flack as the chief strategist in the campaign. There were times when the critics and the media and elsewhere said you were screwing this up, and then there was talk that in the final weeks that your role was reduced, or at least you became less visible. Was that hard for you to deal with?
No, listen, I not in the least.
You have a suit of armor? You don't have any feelings about being criticized?
I've said this before. I'll say it again. It is good that people are upset that the Romney campaign lost. It's good that people are angry. You know, I played in a lot of sports teams. The worst thing is to be in a losing locker room and people aren't upset. This is a moment we should be going through. It's good. And if we look, I was senior strategist for this campaign. We don't have to look for whose fault this loss is any further than me. I take full responsibility. Let's posit that and let's move on. Let's don't have a period where we go back and we try to say, well, let's blame this person, this blame. Just blame me. That's fine. And let's move on.
All right. So you
and let's go on and win races,
right,
and learn from what we did.
But now a lot of the media scrutiny of the Republican debate within the party about whether it's a moderate, the Karl Rove wing, for lack of a better term, versus the Tea Party wing, there's still blame against Romney. For example, the poor showing among Hispanic voters for talking about self-deportation, and that is affecting the immigration debate. Do you think that's fair?
No, not at all. In all of these states where there were contested Senate races, Governor Romney did better than Senate candidates. So we have problems with this. We're going to talk about Hispanic voters. We have problems with Hispanic voters going into this primary, which are very serious problems for the Republican Party. And there's not going to be any quick fix for that. Immigration isn't a quick fix. Having Hispanic candidates isn't a quick fix. It has to be a series of steps to rebuild a bond of trust with Hispanic voters. The primary, I don't think, was positive for that, but there's no data to indicate that the primary was particularly toxic for it.
Okay, let me move on to this question. If there was, in your view, a distorted picture of Mitt Romney, of people, you know, the constant critique that he wasn't a comfortable politician, that he was awkward, that he had trouble connecting with ordinary voters, to some extent, was that his fault? Was that your fault? Was the campaign's fault? Or you think it was kind of a press creation?
I think, listen, every campaign since the beginning of time believes that their candidate's not portrayed correctly. I mean, I just think this is a universal truth in all of politics, and you have to accept that and sort of not get hung up on it. Campaigning for president is a series of sort of kabuki play set pieces that you go through. It is difficult to convey the totality of someone in those moments. Now, one of the...
You're being restrained here in not blaming the press. I'm sure at the time you felt like you weren't getting a fair break from the press, particularly on some of these controversies.
Look, I'm not going to get baited into press bashing here because I really do think that there's...
This is the world we live in.
There's tremendous pressure on the press now to do something that they're not being equipped to do to the level that they would like to do, for, you know, large economic forces. That said, I also do believe, as I said, that if you look at who these reporters end up supporting, they sort of come more from a world that is more of a democratic world. And you can ask why, and there's a lot of questions, why aren't more young Republicans from Iowa or Dallas
going into journalism?
And we would be better served if they were.
How often do you see somebody in a political defeat say, just blame me? You can see more of the interview at CNN.com/reliable source.